What we found is that, yes, the economy where we are is really quite bad, but we've been able maybe not to grow the 5 or 10% that we maybe would like to or traditionally have, but we have been able to hold our own. And I think anybody can do that. And I really think if you're doing a great job with your customer service, because you got to do that, and a great job with the medicine, going beyond what you have traditionally done, that you can do well. Be optimistic. Don't be naive about it. It's a lot of hard work, but it's a really great opportunity to really get involved with things that you haven't been doing in the past. What we've talked about with our doctors, and actually one strategy I think is to get with your team and hold a meeting and say, this is really what we want to be thinking about and emphasize what we can do. So you don't want to turn a blind eye to the fact that the economy is here, but really take more of a proactive position. So we really focused when we had our meeting in the beginning of the summer, which is a busy time in Michigan, and we know we're going to see most of our clients sometime in the next 3-4 months, to one, do a really great job with the clients, because during these times, I think you're going to have to make sure that you're really doing the red carpet treatment for these folks. And what I've seen is clinics that do a really good job are going to keep those clients. The other, in terms of the medical aspect, is what are all the things that we can do, should do, what are our missed opportunities? And when we really sat down as a group and looked at those, boy, there's a lot of things that you can do and reasons to be optimistic, where I think you can do even better than you've done before, because now you're saying, boy, we've got to be on our toes, we've got to, really make sure we're doing the best medicine, everything we can do for that pet. So we focused, number one, on compliance issues, which is, has already been a big topic in veterinary medicine. So there's a lot of room for improvement there. Now, I've had meetings with other doctors outside of our clinic, and sometimes they say, well, we're doing all these things. But the reality is, if you really sit down and measure those numbers, chances are you can't tell me what your compliance rate is, be it with vaccines, stool samples, in particular, missed opportunities and things like wellness screening, dental procedures. So we really look closely and say, maybe our dentistry is 2-4% of our practices, but how high could it be or should it be? And so instead of sitting back and maybe not investing in dental equipment, we've gotten pretty aggressive in obtaining dental x-rays and high-speed drills, things like that. So it is an easy time to, again, react and not want to spend any money. On the other hand, I think you have to think a little bit outside the box and say, where are our growth opportunities, and why can't dentistry be 10 or 15% of our practice, since, we're their total dentist. And we spend a lot of time personally with our dentists. So a lot of missed opportunities that we looked at and really started emphasizing, key things for us, dental procedures, not just the dental cleanings, wellness, health screening, senior care. And I think the list, goes on and on, but it's the time to really do them instead of just talk about them.